In this video, we will discuss the clinical uses of parasympathomimetics. Before going into detail, let's classify the parasympathomimetics for better understanding. Parasympathomimetics are classified as direct acting and indirect acting agonists. Direct acting agonists are further divided into choline esters and alkaloids, while indirect acting agonists or anticholine esterases are classified as reversible and irreversible agents. Here, choline esters of the direct acting agonists include acetylcholine itself and other drugs like bethanechol, methacholine, carbachol, sevimeline, and varenicline. While on the other hand, the alkaloids include pilocarpine, nicotine, and muscarine, clinically important agents. Anticholine esterase reversible agents include hydrophonium, piezostigmine, neostigmine, pyridostigmine, rivastigmine, imbenonium, galantamine, tacrine, and donepezil. While the irreversible anticholine esterases include organophosphate compounds like ecotypate and insecticides that are ferrothione and melathione, and narrow gases like summon and sarin. Here, we are going to discuss their clinical uses one by one, and let's start with the direct acting cholinergic agonist. And the first one is the acetylcholine. Well, acetylcholine acts as a neurotransmitter and, being a nitrogenous compound, bear a positive charge and cannot cross the biological membrane if given orally. Acetylcholine lacks therapeutic application because it has a diverse sites of action by acting on both muscarinic as well as nicotinic receptors. And secondly, it is rapidly metabolized by the choline esterase enzymes present in the plasma. But in contrast, it is used topically. Next, we have bethanechol. Bethanechol has a strong muscarinic activity and lacks nicotinic activity. The enzyme acetylcholine esterase cannot metabolize this drug and is hydrolyzed or metabolized by other esterases. Bethanechol has mainly muscarinic actions, showing some selectivity on the gastrointestinal tract and urinary bladder motility. Thus, it can be used therapeutically for non-obstructive urinary retention, megacolon, which is the abnormal dilation of the colon without mechanical obstruction, and postoperative ileus, which is the disruption of the normal peristaltic movement of the GI tract after a surgical procedure. The next drug is methacholine. Methacholine is also resistant to hydrolysis by the acetylcholine esterase enzyme, and it has a high affinity for the muscarinic receptor in contrast to nicotinic receptors. Methacholine can be used for the diagnosis of bronchial hyperactivity or asthma. Next, we have the carbachol. Carbachol shows an affinity for both muscarinic as well as nicotinic receptors, and it is a poor substrate for acetylcholine esterase enzyme and has a prolonged duration of action. Carbachol has profound actions on the cardiovascular system and GI tract, but the receptor unselectivity limits its therapeutic application, and therapeutically only used locally for its meiotic effect on the eye in glaucoma by decreasing the intraocular pressure. The following agent is sevimeline. Sevimeline acts as a direct cholinergic agonist and mainly works on muscarinic receptors. And therapeutically, it is orally used for xerostomia or dry mouth. The last choline ester in the direct-acting cholinergic agonists is a varenicline. Varenicline is a selective nicotinic agonist and is exclusively used for smoking cessation. Then, we have the alkaloids here, in which the first one is the pilocarpine. Pilocarpine is an alkaloid derived from Pilocarpus micropallis and other species. It is resistant to hydrolysis by the enzyme acetylcholine esterase. It has mainly muscarinic actions and can cross the blood-brain barrier. Pilocarpine is a potent stimulator of sweat, tear, and saliva secretions, but its non-selectivity among receptors limits its uses clinically. Therapeutically, pilocarpine is used topically for its meiotic effect to overcome the mydriatic effect associated with atropine. It is also used for treating glaucoma and as the drug of choice for emergency lowering of intraocular pressure. Pilocarpine oral tablets are used for treating Sjogren syndrome, characterized by dry mouth and lack of tears. In case of toxicity, atropine is used as an antidote. The next one is nicotine. Nicotine is a main constituent of tobacco. It has a strong affinity for only nicotinic choline receptors, and that's why these receptors are named nicotinic. Nicotine is mainly used for smoking cessation, while non-medical uses include smoking and insecticides. After this, we have muscarine. Muscarine binds to muscarinic receptors selectively, and the classification of the receptors is such is derived from this fact. Muscarine is found in poisonous mushrooms and does not used therapeutically, but it has toxicological importance. In case of poisoning with muscarine, atropine is used parenterally as an antidote. And with this, thanks for watching. If you are still watching this video, please do like and share this video, and support us by subscribing to our channel.